So I'm going to go through a song of mine called Imogen Heap. This is kind of whizzing past on 18 years of my life. This song, actually no, 16 years, this was written 4 years ago. And only until recently I've actually been able to perform it again live on stage. Because I wrote this song originally for a different pair of gloves with a different piece of software. And this song was entirely created as a project to try to get the gloves to the stage where I, as a musician, could write a song with the gloves and perform a song with the gloves, entirely with the gloves. And that was the goal that I gave our now, five members on the gloves team. And I gave myself what I thought was plenty of time. I gave myself what I've been working on it for like a couple of years, but for this push to get to the point where I could program using my using Ableton software, a system that I use live space called Ableton. It's a digital workstation, and basically enables me to do like play sounds and basically all the kinds of things you can do in a studio but on the stage. But I didn't want to do that by pressing buttons and kind of running back to the base station like this. I kind of wanted to do something, or press the keyboard like record, play, or bring up a fader or down a fader. It's just, that's what I've been doing throughout my life, performing. I've been using these little keyboards and I'd have to be over here to do anything. But I wanted to be able to sculpt sound. I wanted to be able to catch my voice and release it and repeat it, in the room. Or I wanted to be able to move things from left to right. I wanted to play the bass line like a basketball, specifically for this song. So I'm going to, now the other thing that just happened just before Jonathan invited me back on the stage was one of my batteries died. And that wouldn't have been bad, because we have a spare battery, but the spare battery, these are off the shelf, the glove thing, meaning the batteries. The rest of it's made by myself and the team, but they got severed there, and then they don't work. So I've now only got these batteries left, so I'm going to turn them off and on only when I absolutely need them, because otherwise if they run out of battery, that's it, no more battery. So what I'm going to do is, I haven't really got this prepared, but I thought you might like to see how the song's made. So I'm going to do something. I'm going to stand over here, and I'm going to do this. I'm going to do that. I'm going to do something else. Hello, are you paying attention? Now, usually I'd have a second screen, but I didn't bring a second screen because that's what I can't do. And now my Kinect, which is up front here, I've got a little Kinect, Xbox Kinect thing. And at the moment, I can see two users, but there's only one of me. Isn't there only one of me? You can also see one. But for some reason, this thing thinks there's two of me. Okay, now there's only one. That's good. So when I'm in this position, actually, no, I'm not going to work. You are not very nice to me. No, you're not very nice. He's not doing what he's meant to be doing. I'm sorry. Lights for feedback, and inside they've got some buzzers so I can tell when something's happened or when something hasn't happened. I've also got, so basically recognise my postures, so I calibrate them by getting my lap. And then it recognises, okay, there are my extremities, and then I can train postures, so I train like one finger point, two finger point, articulate, T finger, rock, fist, puppet hand, open hand, pinch, and superficial. And then with my little postures. And then I have my different movements. So I've got pitch, yaw, and roll. So I'm doing all of these things. And then sometimes I've got different zones that I kind of bring things in and out of. So all of those combined together are how I do this song. So there's nothing that's pre-programmed in this at all. But I'm not having my harmonizer because it's in the wrong key, and I'm having issues with my response. It's going to be a different kind of version. And I've only got two levels left in my life. Oh my god. Okay, stop doing that. Right. Maybe I should just play the song. I'm going to just play the song because I haven't got that much battery left, okay? So this is me being a machine. This is me a machine. Okay. Here's some water. Machine needs water too. Okay. As you can see, two users. So I'm using the Kinect as a, basically, yeah, as a kind of proximity to the audience changes how the effect of the sound of the song. I really like that because I've never done that before. I like this idea that me getting closer to you and further away from you is a kind of creative factor of the songwriting. So there's little microphones in my wrists as well. They're also running out of battery. It's all going well. I don't have spare ones of those because that's just the way I'm going. Okay, slightly feeding back there. Okay. Thank you.
sense of it. And that's it for me. It's like breaking down the boundaries between artists and the audience, and between the tech and humans. So humanizing the tech.